Fine. Hey guys, so this is a really unique video. I'm pretty excited to share the news, but today is the first day in which I'm off lithium. I started lithium back in 2012 and it's now 2019, so it's been 7 years. So it's been 7 years and I'm finally off lithium. Now the reason why I'm off lithium is twofold. Number one, it's likely causing weight gain, and number two, there's future problems in which it would cause thyroid issues and possibly kidney issues. Now, the reason why this is an issue in the past is because when I reduced my medications, I had issues with problems like suicidal ideations coming back, and I ended up getting hospitalized because of it. But I didn't have any other precautions. This time I took precautions such as increasing my Latuda, and that has helped tremendously. I started with 60 milligrams of Latuda. I increased that to 80. I was on that for 3-4 weeks, and then I increased that to 100. So I'm on 100 milligrams of Latuda. So every 3 to 4 weeks, I would decrease my lithium, and now I went from 1,200 milligrams of lithium down to 800 to 6, I mean down to, what was it, 1,200 to 900 to 600 to 300 to 0. So right now, today is the day, 2/12/2019, which I'm on 0 milligrams of lithium. I'm feeling pretty good. I'm hoping this will be a great year in which I am on a good pace. Last week was a week in which I was the heaviest I've ever been in my entire life. I was at 174.4 pounds. I dropped 3 pounds, and now I'm at 171.4 pounds, and I believe it's not because of medication. I believe it because I was sick. I also believe that because of the issues, I've started taking a new drug called Topamax. It's usually to treat seizures, but I'm hoping it also help with weight issues. I'm hoping that this will help me lose weight.
So what's your viewpoint on bipolar and medicine in general? You tell them that they should be, go on it, or you feel like it's situational and you're ready to, your reasoning?
I think the reasoning when it comes to medication.
Why are you feeling so healthy? What are you doing?
I think a lot of it is situational. I'm feeling a lot better now and more hopeful, and I feel like this is the best situation to do right now. You all have to outweigh the benefits versus the consequences, and right now I feel like I don't want to gain any more weight. If I will, I'm going to get more frustrated. I'm going to hate myself more if I gain any more weight. Like I said, I've been the heaviest I ever been in my entire life, and I don't like it. So I have to make drastic changes right now. And like I said, physically right now I'm at the worst handicap I ever been. Right now I have a herniated disc, and it's so severe that I feel like I almost need back surgery. It's been like this since October, and because of this issue, I used to work out 3 hours just to maintain my weight. Not only that, I've been gaining weight working out 3 hours a day, 6 days a week, and I've still been gaining weight.
In 2016 and 2017, you lost weight. So what med caused you to gain weight, you think?
There's definitely an issue and discrepancy when it comes to medication. There's likely a scenario which I believe that the lithium did not cause my weight gain.
So what is?
I believe the Cymbalta has caused my weight gain. I also had decreased my Cymbalta from 120 to 60. There's a likely scenario where I'll be getting off the Cymbalta as well.
Are you?
If this does not work, I'll be getting off the Lamictal from 100 milligrams to 50 down to zero.
Is your goal to get off all meds though?
I'm going to have to at least probably stay on the Latuda at 100 milligrams, but...
You're going to go on Trazodone then?
The doctor believes that I should not go on Trazodone because he still believes that I'm bipolar and that it's definitely going to cause some bipolar and manic issues.
What's your viewpoint on your bipolar? You think it's an illness you can control, or what's your advice to people that... about people that are afraid of gaining weight but are mentally unhealthy though?
My issue with that is that you're going to have to trust your intuition on this because...
And do you think Mad Broad is better to be big and happy or unhappy and skinny?
This is going to be based on your intuition. If you want to survive, you're going to have to make sacrifices. And so you're definitely unhappy, do you want to just be unhappy and skinny the rest of your life? Or do you want to be a fat toad?
You lived that life and you weren't that happy being skinny though.
I might have lived that life, but I'm at a different state of mind where I feel like I can be skinny and happy at the same time.
But it's because you're mentally healthy, though.
Right now, I feel like I can manage my life where I can be skinny and happy at the same time. And right now, I'm fat and happy at the same time, so... I don't think there's going to be much of a difference.
But what's your advice to people that are unhappy... And do you think they should still go to the med route like you did and you don't regret it?
I don't regret the med route at all because the reality is if you're bipolar, you're going to have to take some meds anyway. Because do you want to be addicted to something and end up using that addiction the rest of your life and spend a whole bunch of money on that? Or do you want to be taking medications to control that?
Do you think Nancy needs to go on medications
for? Because I know someone who spends $400 just to smoke cigarettes.
Do you think she needs to take meds for her borderline personality disorder?
The reality is, according to my therapist, there's no medication to solve borderline personality disorder. See, there's therapy can't cure it, and medication can't cure it. You can manage it, but.
She's still working, so that's all that matters. She just can't have close relationships. Alright.
Anyways, that's it, folks. So,
he's doing a lot better. Don't give up hope. You can cope. And it just proves that you don't have to be the same person. Because Travis used to require all these meds, but he's been working on music and living... Rather than surviving, it's now more about living. He's going back to his passions and continuing a positive outlook and able to be healthy while doing so.
Take care. Bye.
Bye.